Sukkot Daf Beis. I'd love to welcome the close to 2,000 new viewers to the regular shiur. Over 1,500 people received a brand new Gemara, the Art Scroll or Masifta. So welcome to the shiur. Before we begin, I'd like to take this opportunity to go through some of the pros and the cons of Daf Yomi, what people say, some of the Yitzharas. People say that Daf Yomi, you don't retain much, it's way too fast. In yeshiva, we learned with a lot of lumdas, we learned it slower. And that's all good. The question is, are you really learning every day slow with lumdas and retaining, or just an excuse? One of the biggest pitfalls that the Yitzhar has is that you are going to miss a daf here and there. It's inevitable. There's simchas and rachmal islan, the opposite, and you're going to miss a daf here and there. And what do you do when you miss a daf? The Yitzhar always says, let's make it up. And the idea is always stick to what the daf yomi is at. As we like to say, learn now, catch up later. And if you do that, you'll avoid a tremendous pitfall and be able to stay on the bandwagon of the daf yomi. Some people are asking, well, how will I make a Siyum HaShas with everybody in MetLife Stadium? And the answer is you won't. They started 550 days ago. The Shas is like a Ferris wheel. Wherever you get on, that's where you get off. If you got on the Masechta Sukkah, you'll get off at the end of Yuma. That will be your Siyum. It's okay. If you'd like to make it up, it's not the greatest idea, but it's doable. But don't look at the other people who are making a Siyum in Brachas. Shas starts in Sukkah. Shas starts in Gittin. It can start in the middle of a Masechta. Now let me go through some of the pros of the Daf Yomi. We love to say, it's not about the Daf, it's about the Yomi. Learning Torah consistently, every single day, whether it's Tisha B'Av, Yom Kippur, Chol HaMoed, Erev Shabbos, Shabbos, Sunday, we're always learning a Daf Gemara. The Daf makes you a better person. It's guaranteed. A better husband, a better father, a better businessman. And there's a tremendous camaraderie within our shir, tremendous, tremendous achdos of people of all sorts getting along and loving each other. Shas, as the Rishonim, as Tosfos says, encompasses everything within the Torah. Kabbalah, Tanakh, Halacha. That's why we learn Gemara. And every day, you will learn a brand new concept that you haven't known before. You'll find yourself learning in places and times that you've never learned before. You'll be learning on the plane instead of watching a movie. You'll be learning in a waiting room. That's just the way Daf Yomi is. And if you learn the Daf right after Shachar, so before Shachar, so you're starting off your day on the right foot with a Daf Gemara. And finally, when you have that daily commitment, it helps you in many other areas, such as Shnayim Mikra V'Lecha Targum, and in Gashmias, in dieting, etc. It teaches you how to be committed to something and stick with something. You should have tremendous Hatzlacha. We should finish Masechta Sukkah together, Be'ezer Hashem, all of Shas together. Sukkah Daf Beis. Sukkah, as the Torah says, if it's taller than 20 amma, which today is approximately 40 feet, is possible according to the Tanakhama, Rabbi Yehuda says it's kosher. If a sukkah is less than 10 tefachim, or it doesn't have three walls, or it has more sun coming through the schach than shade, it's possible. The fact that the Mishnah doesn't tell us how to fix it, like the Mishnah says by a mavoi. A mavoi is an alleyway that leads, you go from your chatzar into the mavoi, and midrash you like carry there in Shabbos, but Chacham said it looks too much like a Rosh Hashanah rabbin, and they said you have to put a lechi or a kaira beam. And if the beam is taller than 20 amma, it's possible. And the Mishnah says, make it lower. So how come the Mishnah over here doesn't say lower? Because over here, we're going on a derech. It already says in the Torah something about a sukkah. Now it's telling you that the sukkah cannot be more than 20 amas. And if it is, it's possible. But by a mavoi, Chacham made that halacha up. So it doesn't make sense to say puzzle. What's puzzle? They didn't tell us about it. First they have to tell us the different concepts, and then they can tell us that it's puzzle. Another shot is, by sukkah, there's many different things in our Mishnah. There's four different things. It's too tall, too short, it doesn't have enough walls. So it would be too many words to tell us what you have to do and how to get out of it. Whereas by mavoi, there's only two halachas, and one word fits it both. You make it less than 20 amas, you make it less than 10 amas wide. Now why is it that a sukkah that's above 20 amas is possible? We have a three-way machlokes. Rabbi says, because it says in the pasuk, "Man yedu l'risecha." You should know, says Rabbi, that when you're in the sukkah, you're sitting in a sukkah, and up until 20 amma, a person knows that he's sitting in a sukkah, because his eyes follow the wall where he's sitting, and they go all the way up to the schach. But more than 20 amas, he doesn't see the schach, and he doesn't know he's in the sukkah. the others don't agree with Rava, because that pasuk is referring to in the future. We should know even today. Why do we sit in a sukkah? Because of the Anani HaKavod. But it's not that you have to sit in a sukkah and know that you're sitting in a sukkah. You just have to know why you're sitting in a sukkah. Reb Zera says in the pasuk, sukkah teal itself, sukkah is for shade. Up until 20 amos, the schach provides shade, but above 20 amos, since the sun comes from the side, the schach itself doesn't provide shade. And if you're sitting between mountains, that's not a problem, because if you take away the mountains, it'll come out that your schach provides shade. But the others don't like his pshat, because the pasuk is talking about when Mashiach comes, Mishborcha will make us sukkahs for shade. Rava says the pshat is, sukkahs teish v'shivas yamin. You have to leave your permanent housing, go into a temporary house, until 20 amas. Usually, you can build it, or people build it, temporary. And even if you build it made out of metal, you're yaitza because you could have made it not out of metal. But above 20 amas, you have to build it with a permanent build. And even if you built it with a temporary build, you're still not yaitza. There are three shitas in the name of Rav. Three Amarayim said, this is what Rav said. One said, machlekes between Rabbi Yehuda and Chachamim the Mishnah, if something could be above 20 amas, is when the walls don't reach all the way to the schach. But if the walls reach all the way to the schach, Chachamim agree that even above 20 amas is kosher. Why? Because this would go according to Rava, that the problem is not being able to see the schach. And if the walls don't reach the schach, then your eyes stop wherever the walls stop. But if they reach the schach, you don't have a problem even if it's more than 20 amas. You'll notice the schach. The Braisa says, machlekes is, according to Inra, when the sukkah doesn't have 4 amas. That would be like Reb Zera, that you need the shade of the schach, and more than 4 amas wide, the shade from the schach. And finally, in the name of Rav, machlekes is when the sukkah doesn't have 7 by 7. But that doesn't go according to any of the shittas that we said, whether it requires shade or it has to be a temporary sukkah. But we could say that even if you say the machlekes is when you don't have 4 amas, everybody agrees that the sheer sukkah, and that's the halacha in fact, as we'll see tomorrow, the sukkah has to be 7 by 7. Just he holds the machlekes is between 7 tefachim and 4 amas, whether or not it could be above 20 amas. Why? Because more than 4 amas, it definitely makes shade. The Gemara says there's a story with Hilni Amalka, the Chacham came to visit her aunt Sukkah, and her Sukkah was taller than 20 amas, and they never mentioned a word to her. So Chacham said there's no raya from a woman. That's why they didn't say anything to her, because she's part of her Sukkah, but they said to her, she had 7 sons, and it's impossible that one of them wasn't in the age of Chinuch, 5 to 6 years old. And she did everything based on what Chacham said. Now, this is understood according to my Nama that says that we're talking about that the walls don't reach the schach, because over here, she's a queen, and queens would sit in a sukkah that the walls don't reach the schach. But according to the Nama, it says, the machlokes is in a sukkah that's 7 by 7. Usually a queen wouldn't be sitting in something like that. But in this case, yes, she had her own little private sukkah off the very large sukkah. Chacham hold that her sons sat in a regular sukkah. But Rabbi Yehuda says, no, her son sat with her. And the fact that they didn't say anything to her is a raya that such a sukkah is kosher. Have a wonderful day and welcome to Masechta Sukkah.